suffering from heat exhaustion suffered at last week's game. Johnny Majors is confident the backup pup can get the job done until Smokey is healthy. And finally, a way for fans to show their undying devotion. The Loretta Company offers custom coffins in Alabama, Tennessee, and Auburn colors, complete with official team logos. So far, more than a dozen have been sold at about $2,000 each. This Vols fan says it's the only way to go.
I bleed orange, and I love the orange, and that's the ultimate in there, is when the last, all things are said and done, you know, that's the way to go, in the big orange.
A new meaning to the term diehard fan.
Sorry about that.
Up next. Striking hard and striking fast, the Tennessee Volunteers have found the end zone with All-American candidate Carl Pickens deep and early in their two previous games. Now 2-0, the Vols balance the attack behind a strong, youthful running game, while a swarming defense and mild sanctions from the NCAA this week has Johnny Majors poised for another run at the SEC crown. It's been 6 years since Mississippi State started 3-0, but the presence of Jackie Sherrill has made an immediate impact in Starkville. An overachieving defense that has not allowed a touchdown this season, and a no-huddle offense featuring elusive quarterback Sleepy Robinson takes newfound confidence to the road for the first time this year. A battle of unbeatens next.
From Neyland Stadium on the banks of the Tennessee River, TBS Sports is proud to continue our eighth consecutive season of SEC football. Today we're in Knoxville, Tennessee, as Jackie Sherrill brings his 24th-ranked Mississippi State Bulldogs face-to-face with Johnny Majors and the 6th-ranked Tennessee Volunteers. Hello, everybody. Along with Tim Foley, this is Bob Neal. And let me get a couple of news items out of the way before we talk about these football teams. First of all, people here in Volunteerland are relieved. Mild reprimand from the NCAA following the investigation against the volunteer program. There will be no bowl or TV sanctions. And some news that's not so good, that's got everybody concerned. Last week, Smokey, the 9-year-old blue tick hound, went down in the heat. He's been released from the hospital, and Smokey is watching on a farm outside of town. This is Woody, the backup. Now, he's wearing Smokey's jersey, and it is something for Tennessee Vol fans to be, but Woody said to be ready.
Well, you know, as people recover emotionally from this announcement, we'll talk about the football game a second. Tennessee's offense is going to show up today. He's okay. They're healthy, and they're going to be led by Andy Kelly, who was our player of the week last week for his performance against UCLA. And Phil Fulmer, the offensive coordinator here at Tennessee, was a lineman. Linemen love to talk about establishing the run. But against this stingy Mississippi State defense, which in his first three games has not yet surrendered a touchdown, look for Tennessee to start throwing the ball early on to make progress.
Now, coming into this ballgame, Mississippi State number one in the conference in rushing. Tennessee, statistically, number one in defensing the rush.
Yeah, but they've played Louisville and UCLA, and they're pass-oriented offenses, and it's been fun for their defensive line, which they've built their defense around. These linemen have really got to get in the blocks and really go after these quarterbacks. Quarterback wasn't going to move around much. It's going to be a different game for them today. It's going to be interesting to watch and see if they can be patient enough not to just blast across, but to play more laterally as opposed to vertically.
Tim and I were here back in 1986 with another elusive Bulldog quarterback. Don Smith led the Bulldogs to a 27-23 upset over Tennessee. Is it a big game? Well, Ron Thulin's with us again. That proves it is. And Ron is not only inside and around the stadium, he's down in the Tennessee River.
Bob and Tim, Tennessee football is more than just a game for most of their fans. It is an incredible party. They come by planes, trains, automobiles. How about boats? Right now, more than 100 boats line the shores of the Tennessee River in anticipation for today's game. They'll make the short trip right up to Neyland Stadium. Now, these Tennessee fans are hoping they can finally put a blemish on Mississippi State's 3-0 record. 5 times since 1965, Mississippi State has started the season 3-0, not including this year. All 5 times on the 4th game, they lost by an average of 15 points. However, the good news for Mississippi State fans, the last 2 times they have been here in Knoxville, they have won. The last being in 1986, and that is also the last time Mississippi State had a winning season. Now, let's check in with Paul Ryden in today's Old Milwaukee Insider Report.
This is the fifth largest city in Tennessee on football Saturdays. More than 90,000 at Neyland Stadium today, and they are welcoming the undefeated Mississippi State Bulldogs, led onto the field by head coach Jackie Sherrill. He's guided them to that early 3-0 season. He's 47 years old. He entered this year as the nation's sixth winningest active coach. He has won 108 games, lost 45. And his ties, Jackie Sherrill's, go all the way back to Arkansas and Iowa State when he was first hired by Johnny Majors, the head coach at UT. The Volunteers 2-0 in this young season. We saw them last week defeating a sound UCLA team. And Johnny Majors, who was the runner-up for the Heisman in 56 and a real All-American star here at Tennessee, graduated in 57, has a good, solid, explosive Volunteer team ready to meet the Bulldogs today at Neyland Stadium. We'll be back for the kickoff after this. Was 96 degrees. Now it's 66 degrees. Beautiful football Saturday afternoon weather-wise. The series history, Tennessee leads. Chapman is about to kick off for the Volunteers. The Mississippi State Bulldogs have Tony James, 25, and 29, Kenny Roberts, back deep to take the kickoff. And we're underway here at Neyland Stadium in Knoxville. To the 26-yard line. And there, Mississippi State's Bulldogs will go on offense, led by Sleepy Robinson, the 6-foot-tall, 195-pound Tulane. But Tim and I saw him prove to be a very effective quarterback in the Mississippi State upset over Texas. And we're underway from Neyland Stadium. Robinson quickly out to the left side to Tony James. Tennessee is ready. Let's have a look at the Dr. Pepper starting lineups now offensively for Mississippi State. First of all, changes as we go along. Second down, 9. Prince to see the setback. Tennessee with a lot of defensive calls happening here, trying to figure out this multiple attack. Pretty simple. They hand it to Prince. He gets about a yard and he goes down. Casey Rogers keyed the tackle, the defensive left end, and now the Dr. Pepper Tennessee defensive line. Shazon Bradley will head up a good defensive line, and they'll have to stop the run today. Sean Walker, the middle linebacker, playing hurt. They don't know how many snaps he'll be on the field. Dale Carter, the man who was ejected last week, he is back, and he is the star in the secondary for Tennessee. Both of these teams somewhat depleted with injuries in the secondary. Robinson has caught it. The man who got it, 99, Casey Rogers.
These guys as a unit do a better job than anybody I've seen getting their hands up, knocking down passes. As we mentioned earlier, a defensive lineman led this team in passes broken up last year, and it's just a matter of being good athletes and good training.
Still working on the clock. You see the officials having to coordinate it on the sideline. According to our scoreboard clock, only 7 seconds have elapsed, so they'll keep working on that, and we'll keep you posted with the time running in this ball game as best we can. The man you're looking at in the picture there is Mike Riley, who's averaging 41.8 yards per punt. There's the malfunctioning clock. He's a senior from Dumas, Arkansas. Both these teams with very good punters. Tennessee has lined up 10 on the line. They may be going after Riley. Tennessee blocked one last week against UCLA. End over end, Carter at the 34. Avoids the first tackler, but not the second and third. Down at the 36-yard line. Andy Kelly will lead the Tennessee Volunteers onto the field. Andy Kelly, the senior quarterback, who's thrown 5 interceptions this year, 3 last week. The nation in terms of turnover ratio, not so far for the Volunteers.
Well, talking to Phil Fulmer, Bob, that was more than anything else in the first two games, it was a matter of lack of recognition on the part of receivers, them running the wrong route, Kelly throwing the route they should run.
On the first down, Kelly pulls it down, can't find the receiver. under pursuit. He's going to go down at the 29-yard line. Nate Williams. Second down, 17. Out to the 38-yard line, freshman James Stewart. And the defensive alignment now for the Bulldogs. They play a 3-4 defense.
I think you can be more benevolent than shaky. If they haven't allowed a touchdown, I mean, they're doing okay. They may not be the strong part of this team, but they're okay.
Okay. Slightly, possibly shaky, potentially shaky. A little shaky there. The completed pass to Craig Faulkner. Edward Williams covering on the play. Tennessee first down, 16-yard gain.
Let's look at it now from the slot. Craig Faulkner, who caught seven last week against UCLA, coming to the inside. What makes this work is that offensive line has given Andy Kelly a lot of time. Faulkner worked all the way through two lanes before he came open.
First down, Tennessee, from the 43 of the Bulldogs. Right in the middle, almost picked off by Daniel Boyd.
Excellent recognition by the linebacker. Looked to his left, saw Pickens coming. Was able to react to the ball. Kelly looking for Pickens inside. Boyd got a good drop, got his hands on it, almost had his second interception of the year.
Second down, 10, Tennessee now. Daniel. They give it to Stewart. First down, James Stewart to the 32-yard line. Kelvin Knight makes the stop, number 5. That's a gain of 11. Stewart is a 6'1", 195-pound true freshman from Morristown West High School.
Offensive line work. Stoll coming around the corner there. Actually, that was Rodney Gordon pulling from his tackle position. That's what makes Tennessee so dangerous offensively. They stretch out defensively to cover those receivers, and they'll run right at
you. Run right at him again. Stewart successful again. Inside the 30 to the 28-yard line, a gain of about 4 for the freshman tailback. Two really good true freshmen. James Stewart and Aaron Hayden for Tennessee. Hayden injured, won't play today.
And there's Stewart. And Phil Fulmer, the offensive coordinator here at Tennessee, once again said he was not really ready to start, but they felt like they had to go with him. The injury to Hayden is going to give them Stewart more playing time than he might be ready for now because of some pass protections, but they're confident in his ability.
Seventh play of this drive. Kelly with time to throw. It is complete. Two Pickens at the 17-yard line. Gain of 11 yards. First down, Tennessee.
Let's look at Carl Pickens here. He's got 10 catches on the year so far, 200 yards, drives them off, makes the turn. This time, Boyd loses vision a little bit. The cornerback could have sunk in a little more there to help out on Pickens. You just have to be aware of where he is, and you need to take that guy out of the picture as far as Tennessee offensive production.
Pickens emerging as a Heisman candidate. They fake the reverse. This is Stewart. Down inside the 10, tackled by Kelvin Knight.
From Morristown, Tennessee. Let's watch him run. 21 carries so far, averaging almost 6 yards a carry. Fakes the reverse. Heads up in there. A lot of room. Defensive backs making too many tackles for Mississippi State at this point.
Second down, 2 from the 9. Stewart again tries the middle again. Only about a yard this time. Nate Williams is there to plug it up. Tennessee very successful, mixing up the plays, throwing a couple of passes, running it up the middle, and moving it right down the field. That's the 9th play on this drive.
Yeah, they have had some injuries to their linebacker core at Mississippi State. They've got 3 strong defensive linemen. Wouldn't be surprised to see them go with 4 at some time during the game.
Third down, less than a yard. Power formation. Kelly is thrown for a loss at the 12, Tennessee.
The leader in that offensive line.
Kevin Wendelboe for the field goal attempt. Remember the narrow field goal post. No problem for Kevin. A 29-yarder is good, and Tennessee takes the early lead. 3-0 from Neyland Stadium in Knoxville.
looking over Carl Pickens, the All-American. They were looking at his right arm, his right elbow, shaken up during that last offensive series by Tennessee. We will check on what the condition of Carl Pickens is and let you know as soon as we hear. There are the deep backs for the Mississippi State Bulldogs. Tony James, 25, and Kenny Roberts, 29. Joey Chapman will kick it off. Tennessee leads 3-0 early in this ballgame. Malfunctioning clock, by the way, and we'll just do the best we can to keep you posted. We're early in the first quarter. The line drive kick to Roberts. Yes, Kenny Roberts. To the 28-yard line. For the turn of 24 yards, he was hit by Steve Session, and there's the scoring drive, 11 plays, 5 minutes of possession time.
Good mix of the run and pass. They had some long yardage situations. They ran the draw effectively. The Mississippi State came up defensively, came up with the big play when they had to, and forced the three.
Sleepy Robinson, who missed last week's game against Tulane with an ankle injury, practiced all week, said to be in pretty good shape, about 90% on the arc. Tennessee is there. Kenny Roberts is taken down by number 22, Floyd Miley, thrown for a loss.
Well, that's one thing about these Tennessee cornerbacks. You talk to Tim Keene, their coach, and he'll say these guys get into the play. You know, he was a contained man. Most of the time that is strung out. Those guys are running downfield together. Fred Ward tried to get a piece of Miley, couldn't slow him down a bit.
Play call in from the sideline. Single setback, spread formation for the Bulldogs. Second down, 12. Big, and Robinson to throw. Going deep, has a man there. It is complete and out of bounds at the 37-yard line to senior wide receiver Chris Pearl. Big play from the Bulldogs of 37 yards.
For that wide receiver, good throw by Robinson.
Just to give him an idea that, yes, he is an elusive running quarterback, but as you pointed out, Tim, has the ability to throw the ball when he needs to. Effectively on that play. From the 38 of Tennessee. On the option, he cuts it the other way. The elusive Robinson to the 31-yard line. Let's go sideline to Ron Thulin.
Bob, updating you on the condition of Pickens. Right now they say it's a deep bruise in his right arm. As you can see, they're putting ice on it. The doctor said they think he can play, but first they're going to put ice on it to see how he feels, and his status is up in the air. Bob?
Thanks, Ron. How's Woody, the mascot, doing?
Woody is here.
Second down, 7. Make it second down, 4, excuse me, from the 31-yard line. So up the middle, not much more. Chuck Smith with the initial hit for the Tennessee Volunteers.
That time, the right defensive end just closed it down. The tackle slid through on the linebacker, and Smith made the hit on the fullback. That's what the defensive end has to do on that particular play. Robinson coming down. You can't take the fullback for granted. And so Smith nails him. Robinson gave him the ball. Obviously, that wasn't a read. That was a called play.
Third down, short 2. Robinson's going to throw it. Incomplete to Furl. Interesting play call. Penalty marker is down at the line of scrimmage.
And the pass
as long of the year is 35. It is good. Gardner's long of the year now is 46, and this game is tied at 3. 7 minutes, 20 seconds to go in the first quarter. 46-yard field goal from Gardner to match the Tennessee field goal from the foot of Kevin Windelbowl. His was 29 yards. And Pickens back on the field. 15 Pickens, 18 Dale Carter.
Pick your poison on that one. That would cause me to hit a ground ball.
Gardner setting up for the kickoff here. Dale Carter averaging 30 yards per kickoff return, by the way. Leading the SEC. Comes down to Carter at the 6. Hit instantly as he drilled right at the 10. What coverage from the Mad Dog. K kickoff coverage team. I understand, by the way, that this mostly volunteer kickoff team for Jackie Sherrill, which primarily plays at home games in Starkville.
Tennessee likes to go deep here. They like to try to get one in a hurry, and they've got people, obviously, that can do it.
The handoff to the right side being coupled by Kenneth Campbell, the sophomore fullback out of Chattanooga. Campbell, Brunson, Rockpole, Mose Phillips are the fullbacks. We'll be seeing James Stewart and Fabio Henson at the tailback spots today for Tennessee.
One of the things this Tennessee offense doesn't have is a Roland Poles or a Greg Amsler, a big, big back that can block and knock people out of the way. Campbell's more of a runner and receiver.
On the second down, they're going to run it again with more success this time. Out to the 17-yard line, they give it to James Stewart. Stewart, the freshman, is going to get probably a baptism of what it's like to carry the ball all game long. He'll get a lot of carries today, and that's, Tim, as you always point out, a difficult transition out of high school into college.
It is. Give me the ball, give me the ball, give me the ball. But in college, you carry the ball a lot. I mean, you get those guys who are a lot bigger, a lot more momentum they're whacking you with, and the bruises are a lot deeper after a game.
So far, Stewart's had success. Six plays, 40 yards already. William Goss, the referee. Looks like somebody's slightly injured, maybe even a cook.
During his freshman season, he started 26 straight games. And he's really the hub of that wheel in there. Everything revolves around John. John makes all the calls.
Oh, for Carl Pickens, although he's back in the game. And now the center, senior John Fisher, comes off the field. Kelly's going to run it again.
One for Tennessee, right up the middle. Keo Coleman with the tackle on James Stewart.
Watch this Tennessee line work from the end zone. Just good area blocking, good cross blocking by Maslinski. You see him still working, and it's just opening up inside. Coleman and Boyd are going to have to fill that a lot quicker.
First down 10 from the 33. It was filled quicker that time. Kenneth Campbell took the brunt of the punishment. Arlie Gibson keyed the tackle, number 90. 3:23 to go first quarter. Tie game 3-3 from Knoxville.
And last year's Tennessee's offense averaged 205 yards throwing the ball and 205 yards running the ball per game. This year they're a little bit higher on passing than they are on rushing. They talked about trying to get some work in early on getting more yards on the ground.
The play fake this time, and Kelly can't find the receiver, and he goes down right at the line of scrimmage at the 31. Good job of movement there by Kelly just to get out of a big loss. Mark Woodard and Jerome Brown were back there. Brown really the sack leader on this Mississippi State team.
Get a flag down here, and a good job by in either college or pros, I think, to play out on the corner.
Pickens at 6'3". Here's the flea flicker, the handoff, the pass back to Kelly. Kelly's not going to get rid of the ball. He tried to throw it, it looked like, after he went down. Stephen Henry. That's a live ball. Tennessee fell on it. Now it popped loose again down there at the 46-yard line. They're giving it to Tennessee.
You could tell the way the head referee was tracking that ball. The one kid ran by it. It was ruled a fumble.
Tennessee remains in possession of the ball at the 46-yard line.
And Frankie Lester had an opportunity to pick this up. Let's take a look at it here. It's a flea flicker. Mississippi State plays it well. Defensive backs back. Kelly forced out, and I'm not sure what that was about. Obviously trying to avoid the sack, but
he threw it forward.
He did throw it forward.
Either
but they ruled it a fumble.
I don't understand the call.
Down to the 49-yard line of the Bulldogs. Daniel Boyd with the stop.
Well, if it was an incomplete pass, wouldn't you have to say intentional grounding on something like that? I mean, if you're not looking in the direction you're throwing the ball, you give him a right-hand hook.
He did intentionally throw it. If he was down, it would have just been down.
Yep.
Nevertheless, Tennessee fell on it anyway. Basically a moot point here. It is third down and 5. We see a new one every week. Time out. The 49 of the Bulldogs. It is complete for the first down at the 33-yard line. And down there making the reception, number six, little J.J. McCluskey.
J.J.'s a converted defensive back. You saw him score a touchdown last week against UCLA on a reverse. And Kelly doing a good job going to his second receiver. McCluskey had driven off. Edward Williams coming back at the ball. Nice job.
First down, Tennessee. They spotted right at the 32-yard line, right side hash mark. Out of the eye this time. Here is Stewart, hit in the backfield, broke a tackle again. Strong young man to the 28-yard line. The ankle tackle didn't get him.
Well, John Majors, as we talked to him in his office, talked about his hope that this young man could come in as a true freshman and make a difference because they had just been stung severely by graduation. He was hoping that both he and Hayden could come in and play because they needed someone this year. They didn't need one someone to develop over time.
On second down, five, finding some success up the middle. Again, inside the 25 goes Stewart. Juan Long makes the stop this time. And by the way, Spivey's still in there at center for Tennessee, but we understand that nothing is wrong with Fisher, the starting center for Tennessee, and he will be back in the game. That's the end of the first quarter of play. The score is Tennessee 3, Mississippi State 3. They're going to have to start plugging it right now. Tennessee third down 2 on the first play of the second quarter. Stewart tries the left side. This time does not gain the yardage necessary for the first down. Nate Williams made the tackle again. His fourth, Mark Woodard, stops too. So on third down situations, Tennessee has been stopped twice down here deep. This one is going to be fourth and short. They're going to kick it.
Johnny Majors was eking his way down there to get a, you know, he wanted to get a bird's eye view of exactly how far they had to go. And when he saw it was a couple of yards, he decided to go ahead and take the 3 points. Coaches always like to get the points on the board, especially early on in a football game.
Wendell Bowe kicked the first field goal. This is Joey Chapman, who has the stronger leg. Yard field goal attempt. Right from the center of the field, however. Those kind of little details drive Johnny Majors crazy when they're short a player on the field or something of that nature in execution. That field goal attempt by Joey Chapman is no good, and this game remains tied 3-3. So the Bulldogs kept Tennessee out of the end zone again. Nobody has scored a touchdown on the Bulldogs in 3 games and 1 quarter. We go in the first half of play. Attendance today, 95,974. Tennessee's eighth largest crowd. Went over the 16 million mark. Kenny Roberts with the right side pitch and a gain of about 7 out across the 35.
Mississippi State coming to the line, really overloading one side or the other. They're trying to see how the defensive coordinator here at Tennessee, Larry Lacewell, is going to respond. That time they brought Carter out of the middle of the field and put him up there in a strong safety position.
This will be second down and about 3. Robinson, two receivers left, two rights, and the setback with him breaks. And they give it to Prince, who is stopped short of the first down by Shazan Bradley, number 40. We were talking about Smokey, the mascot, as a Tennessee player is down on the field, and his backup Woody's in there. Ron Thulin, what do you have?
Oh, Bob, you talked about the difference in temperature between this week and last week. Last week, there were 75 calls concerning one thing, only 5 concerning the other. The 75 were concerning Smokey the Sixth. As he was taken out of the game before the game even started with heat exhaustion, Smokey the Sixth is fine. They're giving him the week off because there's a big game against Auburn. They don't want to get him hurt today. Of course, Auburn's next week. And this is Woody. Now, Woody has not lettered. He's planning on getting the 4 quarters today. He will be able to wear the letter sweater. However, he is extremely nervous, Bob. 96,000 people and, of course, a nationally televised game. Woody's nervous, but his trainers tell me he's hanging up there, and he's making me extremely wet right now. Back to you, Bob and Tim.
Thank you very much, Ron Thulin. A more serious note here. That is 45 middle linebacker Sean Walker. The game tied at 3-3. We are early in the second quarter.
Tennessee only giving up about 25% of these third down conversion attempts. Kenny Roberts should have had it. Incomplete.
Yes, he should have had it, and he might have gone a long way if he would have had it. Call this a trips formation, 1-2-3. Carter trying to work his way through their man-to-man. That is his man. There is no one downfield if he makes the catch. Dale Carter probably would have made the tackle, would have been a first down. But another nice throw by Sleepy Robinson. Put the ball on the money.
Mike Riley to punt. Carter back to catch it. Riley got this one up for great hang time. Carter's going to have to fair catch it at the 15-yard line. There, the Volunteers will go back on offense. A 47-yard punt from Riley. 12:42 to go in the first half, tied at 3. 42 to go. We talked about Jackie Sherrill and Johnny Majors' coaching roots going back a long way. Johnny Majors gave Jackie Sherrill his first coaching job, said he probably wasn't even thinking of going into the business. That was at Iowa State. But here the two are together at Pittsburgh in 1975 following a victory in the Sun Bowl. Johnny Majors was, of course, head coach at Pittsburgh from 73 to 76. Sherrill left, went to Washington State, but then came back to replace 80 when Sherrill was the head coach at Pitt, and he brought a tremendous team in here to Knoxville and defeated Johnny Majors, Tennessee Volunteers, 30-6. First down, 10 Tennessee from the 15. And he has McCluskey out of bounds at 28. Harris chased him out.
Spivey's still playing center for Tennessee, and I got to believe that if there was nothing wrong with John Fisher, he would be back in the football game. So now they're playing with a second-team center, and Rodney Gordon is playing for the injured Bernard Daphne.
Yeah, that's a good point, Tim. Our word that we received here in the press box is that Fisher was not injured, but we're going to double-check that. I agree with you. If he's not injured, he'd be there. Stopped at the line of scrimmage at the 28 is James Stewart. Keo Coleman made the tackle. Go with what we see as opposed to what we heard. Second down and 10 for the Volunteers. The play fake. It popped out of the air into a Tennessee lineman's arm. That was Brian Spivey, the center, who caught the ball in the air. Mark Woodard really slammed into Andy Kelly. Third down, 16. Kelly, it is complete for the tight end. Right near the first down marker goes Mark Adams. I think he got enough for the first down. It's going to be close here on the near sideline. Gain of about 17. And it's enough for the first down.
That's a killer defensively. Nice job on offense. They buy Kelly a lot of time. Mark Adams covers a lot of ground, scoots out of the middle, and it's a long time before anybody gets there to help. Knight finally there to help on the tackle, but I think the tight ends here at Tennessee caught 8 passes last week. That might have been more than they caught in 1979.
Stewart with running room. Bulldog territory to the 49-yard line. Edward Williams with a stop. Another first down run by Tennessee. And James Stewart getting up over 70 yards already.
And they are running the ball. This guy looks like he's got good vision. Joseph staying at home. He overruns it. Good tackle by Edward Williams. But it's 10 yards down the field. It is really discouraging for a team to have a third and 16 defensively and have the offense pick it up. Takes him a while to recover.
Kelly, plenty of time to throw. Then he's hit out of nowhere. Comes Torrance Brown. Mark it incomplete. And let's get the update on John Fisher. It looks like he's injured to me, Ron Thulin.
Well, according to John Fisher, he is injured. Now, the doctors and the medical staff took a look at him, and there really wasn't any pain when they were pressing on his right ankle. He said, okay, wrap it up. Let's try to go. They started to wrap it up. He could not push off it. He says, folks, this still hurts. So that is why they've got ice on it right now. And Jeff or John just told us he still can't push off that right ankle, and he's going to have to wait and see.
Second down, 10. Hand off again. Stewart this time gets a yard, not much more. Mark Woodard with the stop.
Mississippi State is leaving the middle of the field open occasionally, and if Tennessee could run one of those wide receivers, Pickens, McCluskey, Faulkner down in there, they could hit him big. It's just a matter of, it's a poker game. Mississippi State realizes that they have to apply pressure, that they can't let Kelly sit back there as the doctors continue to work on Sean Walker.
Third down, 9, 10:04 to go, second quarter. Tie game at 3. Kelly, it is picked off. Out to the 35-yard line comes Frankie Luster, the strong safety. We saw Frankie Luster make some big plays against Texas a few weeks ago.
Bill Clay is the defensive coordinator here at Mississippi State, and we'll talk to you a little bit more about his secondary when we come back.
Elbow two. That's the reason I thought it was Pickens. I think it was Pickens. Out to the 40-yard line comes William Robinson.
Yeah, that was Pickens there.
That's what I thought.
He's a little bit longer.
That's right, and skinnier than Sean Walker. And he did bang his elbow up earlier in the ballgame.
See, Mississippi State calling the plays on the line of scrimmage. It's a no-huddle offense that Watson Brown used at Vanderbilt.
Penalty marker goes down. The middle of the defensive line mixing it up there with Byron Jordan, the junior center for Mississippi State. They're going to mark it off against Tennessee.
We're talking to Larry Lacewell here, the defensive coordinator, former head coach at Arkansas State for 12 years.
Dead ball, offside on the defense, 5-yard penalty, makes the first down.
And also formerly of John Major's staff at Iowa State, he had a six-way bypass 14 weeks ago. We'll get you a shot later on in the game of him. He's a defensive coordinator up here in the box, acting like nothing happened.
Repeat first down. They move it to the 45-yard line of the Bulldogs. Tie game at 3. Robinson on the option. And about 3 out on the right side to Kenny Roberts.
There's Watson Brown. We saw him take a lot of lickings at Vanderbilt. He was outmanned there in terms of talent, and he's done a wonderful job bringing along this young man, Sleepy Robinson. And if something happens to Sleepy, you're going to see another fellow named Greg Plump, who was 8 out of 11 last week against Tulane, who also looks good.
This is second down and a long 7. From the 48 of the Bulldogs. Robinson running the quarterback draw. Tennessee showing patience, and that's something Larry Lacewell said this defensive line would have to do today against this offense.
Yes, he did, because they played against pass-oriented offenses, and defensive ends love the pass rush. Johnny Major will tell you that, and they speak with pride about their 4 defensive linemen. They call lethal weapon 4 defensive ends. Do as much of it today against Robinson.
This game tied at 3. This will be third down, 6. Crowd starting to be a noise factor here. Was Ernest Field along with Chris Mims, and then Bailey came away with it.
Well, they call it Cobra here at Tennessee, and that means we're coming after you, and here they come. See Keith Carr coming upfield, driven outside. Robinson tries to escape. The ball is pulled out by Fields. It was loose on the way down. Tennessee football. Terry Bailey comes up with it.
First down, 10 from the 43 of the Bulldogs. Looked like Tennessee right tackle moved before the snap. As the flags fly.
Did by Falstad on the offensive line. 5-yard penalty, first down.
Mississippi State has a young offensive team, and they've got to understand that when you're playing an aggressive Tennessee defense like this, you're going to have some bad plays. They're going to make you miss. They're going to make you look silly sometimes, but they'll also expose themselves to the big play.
So make it first and 15 now. Back near midfield, they give it to Stewart. He gets about 3 or 4 of the penalty yards back and not much more. Well, last night in Los Angeles, all of us are sleepy here as we stayed up late to watch this ball game. Braves regained first place with a 3-0 victory over the Dodgers. Braves will try to extend their one-half game lead later tonight on TBS at 10 Eastern time. Second down, 13. Kelly hit hard and dropped at the 46-yard line by Jerome Brown. That's his fourth sack of the year. He is the sack leader of this Bulldog team, a loss of 8.
Let's watch it happen. Young man from West Newberry, New York. Pete Jenkins, a defensive line coach for the Bulldogs, said this guy's just learning how to use his skills. And Kelly had Faulkner wide open coming across the middle. Got that. Progresses.
Third and 21. The pump right, the throw left. It is complete to Stewart. He's got running room. He slipped up far short of the first down. Looked like he had some space in which to run. Down at the 43. That's where this drive started.
Well, somebody was saying some prayers on that one because that was 6 points on the board. Stewart was out in the open. Two of those big honkers out in front of him. There wasn't anybody that was going to get through there. He broke down to make a move, and his feet slipped out from under him, fortunately for Mississippi State.
Kelly stays in for the punt formation. He is the pooch punter on this team, but obviously when Kelly's there, it causes Mississippi State to go, well, maybe he'll punt. They're right at midfield. Scott Gumina is back deep at the 10. About 13 yards per punt return. And here's Hutton on the punt for Tennessee. Penalty markers are down. James lets it get into the end zone. A lot of flags on the field today. 49-yard punt from Hutton. Finally, we're back, and Greg Plump is back in at quarterback there. Number 10 is in at quarterback in place of William Robinson for the Bulldogs. Hands it to Roberts. Roberts broke one tackle, got out to about the 13. Plump's the man who replaced Robinson last week, with William having an ankle injury against Tulane and performed very well.
Plump didn't miss a beat last week, ran for 2 touchdowns, threw for 70% completion.
Bad toss, Tennessee ball at the 14. We saw that happened at the hands of Greg Plump in the game against Texas a few weeks ago. Tennessee with another fumble recovery, and this one at the 13-yard line of the Bulldogs. Mims got on the ball. The pitch was intended for Kenny Roberts, number 29.
Trying to get the young man some work. Comes down the line of scrimmage, makes the right decision. He just doesn't get the ball back to the running back. Let's see it again. Good block on Fields. Looked like the play had a chance.
Tennessee's going to run it right side. Gain of maybe a yard or so by James Stewart. His 16th carry of the day. Mississippi State has come away with the ball. Stewart coughed it up. Lance Aldridge was the man who had the football in his hand, number 24. This true freshman, James Stewart, we were talking about how many times can a young true freshman take the hammering at big-time college football without a mistake. Let's see what happens then.
Well, he took a lick here. He's been having some luck. Good job by Aldridge. Turns the play in. Joseph trying to get off the block. It looked like Knight came over the top. Somebody popped him from underneath. Throw the ball out.
Bulldogs back with it. Plump gives it to Prince. Nowhere to go. Tackled by Shazon Bradley, number 40.
4:42 to go in the first half. This game remains tied at 3. Two field goals, a 46-yarder for State and a 29-yarder for Tennessee. Second down, 10. For Greg Plump, the sophomore from Hattiesburg, in there for Sleepy Robinson at quarterback. Timeout called by Greg Plump. We'll be back to Neyland Stadium. See Sleepy Robinson, number 15, the Mississippi State quarterback, who is out of the game right now. Plump came in. We thought maybe he'd been shaken up. He was playing on a sore ankle, but they're not working on his ankle. Has no ice around it or anything, so he's just on the sideline. And Plump in at quarterback with a second down and 10. The Bulldogs out here to the 13-yard line. Plump on the naked quarterback reverse. Good runner. Penalty marker goes down. There was a problem that time. Movement on the line.
Worked successfully in the past for Watson. The noise factor is a factor.
First down 15 now from the 37-yard line. Tennessee defensive players signaling for the crowd to get involved, and they do. Prince with the reception. Down hard at the 37. Game is tied at 3. Neither team able to get under the end zone. That's the play clock. With complete 2, Charlie Davidson, who struggles out here across the 45 to the 46-yard line. Charlie Davidson, by the way, is a freshman who had a broken collarbone. And
after a good initial hit by Jeremy Lakin.
Third down, 5. Receivers to the left, one to the right, single setback. Plump is swallowed up by the on-rushing Volunteer defensive line. Tom Fuller got him this time, number 91, loss of 7 yards.
They're playing combination defense on the strong side here. They're zoning this. Plump was going to throw it. He saw there was no way to go. A cornerback just sitting there waiting to receive the ball, and then Plump wisely ate it.
So Mike Riley's in to punt. Dale Carter back inside his 20. Tennessee having again a mix-up on which players to get on the field. Riley, any clouds in the sky could bring rain with this punt. Carter's fair catches it at the 23-yard line. We understand, by the way, Robinson is okay. They simply wanted to take a look at quarterback Greg Plump. Field are the team to beat in the SEC. If it's not the Gators, the rest of them think it's the other team in orange, the Tennessee Vols. On the first down from the 23. It is complete to Mose Phillips, the redshirt freshman fullback.
Trying to loosen up that Mississippi State defense. Phillips, a good receiver, gets it coming out of the backfield, and Brown makes contact early on. If they can just make contact and hang on, it'll be very helpful as the game proceeds. What they don't want to do is spread out too much and give Tennessee that room inside to run.
Kelly under pressure again. Gets rid of it to Pickens. He's out of bounds at the 32-yard line. A nice safety valve. Good quarterback pressure from Terrence Brown, 48.
Kelly once again under pressure. Stowers upfield. Brown blitzes inside. Torrance Brown has a good opportunity there to make the play. Kelly eludes him and then dumps it off to Pickens, who scoots out of bounds.
You should say just like a wide receiver would. First down, 10. They run it up the middle. Success again, first down. This time it's Mose Phillips out of the fullback spot. Mose is a 6-foot-tall, 215-pound freshman out of Nashville, Tennessee. at 3, minute 25 to go in the half. Kelly tossed it out here to Phillips. It was a forward pass. It'll go as incomplete. Coming up at halftime, the athlete, you said it reminded you of the Dolphins facilities. The minute 18 to go in the first half. Tennessee, second down from the 49-yard line. It is complete. A nicely developed screen to the left side. Stewart inside the 40 to about the 38-yard line before he's tripped up. A gain of 11 on the play.
Daniel Boyd did an excellent job of knifing through that front wall that had got out in front of Stewart. Stewart made him miss. Picked up about 12 more yards.
On the first down, Kelly. Quick snap, quick toss. Complete for the 32 and out of bounds to Corey Fleming. Stewart has been a factor in this game. The freshman has 81 yards rushing, 20 yards receiving the ball. So Stewart with over 100 yards of total offense against, in the first half.
Excuse me, against a team that has only given up 92 yards per game in rushing offense.
Just outside the 30, let's call it second down and 3. Tight end Mark Adams over from the left to the right. Hand off to Stewart. And I think gets the first down. They've got him about the 27 and a half yard line. Kevin Henry made the stop. Clock down inside, a minute, 45 seconds remaining in the half. Remember, Mississippi State has gone 12, 13, and almost 14 quarters into this season without giving up a touchdown.
Well, you can bet Tennessee's going to try to throw it in there at least once into the end zone, at least once before this half is over.
Kelly on first down. It is complete to the tight end. That's Adams. He's down at the 20. And they'll say he got all the way to the 19.
Another good job by Edward Williams. Good jam on the outside, turn back on the inside, and kept the receiver from getting out of bounds.
It was short of the first down, so that means Tennessee had to use a timeout, clean error, and I suppose most of the coaches are deciding simply to try less field goals, although in this game it's been the only story, a 29-yarder for Tennessee and a 46-yarder for Mississippi State. Second down, 1, 32 seconds to go in the half. Now he passes it over the middle, and it is complete to Kenneth Campbell, the first down to the 13-yard line. That'll stop the clock at 24 seconds. Until they set the sticks. Tennessee has the backs of nine.
You got Pickens out here on a 5'9", 5'9" cornerback. And
chance to call their play, second down and 10. They're going to hand it off.
The 3, Kelvin Knight with the stop, clock ticking, 13, 12, and counting. Tennessee has a timeout remaining if they need to use it.
Clock down to 10 and gets stopped. They set the stick. And Kelly again throws the ball down here to stop the clock. With 8 seconds remaining and probably time for just one play. So can the Mississippi State Bulldog defense, which has not allowed a touchdown all year, keep the Volunteers out of the end zone with 8 seconds to go in the half?
Well, Johnny Majors doesn't think, though. They love to run the ball down there. Here they came with a draw again, and they like the quarterback draw. But here I don't think it's going to be a run.
See if they launch Stewart. We saw him launch Stewart, send him airborne last week. He's the single setback.
That's Pickens in the flat.
Kelly Roy looking.
To Corey Fleming. Pickens went to the flat as Tim predicted. So did all of the Bulldog defenders. And they left Corey Fleming alone. And that's the first touchdown of the year given up by the Bulldogs.
just didn't get any containment on the wide side there, Bob. Excellent job of coverage. He was looking for Pickens. He couldn't get to him, and Kelly searched out Corey Fleming, working back against the grain. Nice job by the senior quarterback.
2 seconds left in the half.
Is good, and Tennessee leads it 10-3 at halftime. So Jackie Sherrill will have an opportunity to at least return the kickoff here.
Kelly coming out of there, Pickens in motion in the flat. They do a nice job of covering. It's not there, it's not there. And he picks up that orange jersey drifting back against the sea of white. Fleming gets his feet down inbounds. Here's for the turf toe look. Kelly moving to the left, flicks it, sidearm, back against the grain. Excellent job, good reception by Corey Fleming. I think that's his first touchdown catch.
That was an outstanding 77-yard drive by the Volunteers.
Got a great blend of run pass so far today, and I think that's what they're looking to try to get more of. They've been a little bit too pass oriented as far as Phil Fulmer has been concerned. They're trying to build up their running statistics, and they're heading into the SEC season, obviously, with this game here and then on to Auburn. They want those defensive coordinators to sit down and worry about the run before they start sending linebackers out to mess with Pickens and Faulkner and McCluskey.
See the kickoff for 50 yards. That followed a penalty. It was tagged on after the play. And Tennessee easily boots it in and out of the end zone. So no chance for any return. No, he told you Mississippi State had kept every team out of the end zone, including Texas, until late in the second quarter here, with only 2 seconds to go in the half, and Tennessee scored on the 77-yard drive. So the Bulldogs will have a chance for one play from the line of scrimmage before halftime. And Greg Plump continues at quarterback.
Tennessee's defense certainly has been strong in the first half, with the exception of a big pass from Robinson to Furl. It's really shut down this Mississippi State offense.
At halftime, Tennessee leads it by a score of 10-3. For almost the entire half, nothing but a pair of field goals until Tennessee puts it together, running the ball, passing, mixing it very effectively. Let's go down to the sideline with Ron Thulin and Johnny Majors.
All right, Coach Majors, defensively, you're doing an excellent job. Offensively, a blend of passing and rushing, but it was a big touchdown there at the end.
Big, and big, in capital letters. This is a very intensely played ball game, and both teams are making a few mistakes, but both teams are playing excellent defense. And our offense has got a few folks out there that are not in there right now, but we're doing pretty darn well, and it's a game that's going to go down, I'm sure, to the last minutes of the ball game, quite possibly. Proud of our team hustling.
No change in philosophy offensively going into the second half. There's still the blend of running and passing.
Trying to mix it up, yes.
All right, Johnny, go talk to your team. Johnny Majors, now let's go back up to Bob and Tim.
Thanks, Ron Thulin. So it's 10-3 Tennessee at halftime as they score with 2 seconds remaining in the half. The Aflac
Halftime Report, where right now our score is Tennessee leading Mississippi State 10-3. Hi, everybody. I'm Ron Thulin. Excellent drive by Tennessee. 2 seconds left. They get the go-ahead touchdown. Excellent look by Andy Kelly, and that gave them the 7-point lead. And we will have highlights and statistics coming up. But now let's go to the field and listen to the University of Tennessee Pride of the Southland Band as we check other scores from around the nation. And the band is doing a tribute to 200 years, the city of Knoxville.
Thank you. City throughout its history. Formed by the French Rod and Holston Rivers, the Tennessee River is a resource of undeniable proportions.
Knoxville was born on October 3rd, 1791, when James White organized a lottery, which he raised around the small settlement. The small settlement, the Tennessee River, has grown to become Tennessee's third largest city.
Of the Southland Band from the University of Tennessee celebrating 200 years of Knoxville. Celebrating a 10-3 lead by Tennessee over 92,000 here at Neyland Stadium. And we'll be back as the Aflac College halftime report continues in a moment. Honoring the 40-year anniversary of the 1951 National Championship team here at Tennessee that went 10-1, finished number one in both the AP and UPI polls. Now, a lot has changed here at the University of Tennessee in those 40 years. The obvious change has been in the facilities, as the University of Tennessee has put together one of the all-time great athletic complexes. Here's a look. Not only does Tennessee have the third largest on-campus stadium in the country, few schools can match the outstanding training and practice facilities located in the 120,000 square foot Neyland Thompson Sports Center. The building brings volunteer football to life in the form of the Tennessee Football Hall of Fame. The 101 years of college football in Knoxville are chronicled throughout the various displays, trophies, and plaques that revive memories of great plays, bowl games, rivalries, as well as SEC and national championship teams. The museum stands as a tribute to those who have contributed to the storied history of Tennessee football. Another feature of the center for those involved in the Vols program of today, this 70-yard indoor practice facility that can double as a baseball infield. And when their athletes aren't on the practice field, Tennessee knows weight training.
Our facility is approximately 12,000 square feet. It's one of the top five square foot wise in the country. Our equipment, we have 140 training stations with approximately 48,000 pounds of weights. Our emphasis is total body strength. That's the number one. Then we look at the individual needs and modify their workout so that we are reaching that particular individual.
Now with the complex we have no excuse except to get the most out of our players, whether we win a championship or don't win any of them, and our players should play it to the hilt in every football game we play in.
And that is Johnny Majors. Bruno Paletto, the strength and conditioning coach here at the University of Tennessee, was born in Italy. He is a naturalized citizen of Canada. In fact, he was a member of the 1980 and 84 Canadian Olympic team. 10-3 is our halftime score. The Aflac College Halftime Report will continue in a moment. In fact, saying, hey, let's stick to our game plan. We're stopping ourselves. Mississippi State isn't stopping us. Defensively, it'll be status quo. They feel they're doing an excellent job on the defensive end. We are in Knoxville, Tennessee. Tennessee, a slim lead over Mississippi State. 10-3 is our score, and this has been the Aflac College Halftime Report.
It's remaining. It was fourth down scored. I'm not even sure Johnny Majors was aware of that because the scoreboard clock did not show fourth down, and they had a rollout pass for the touchdown. I'm sure if I'm Johnny after the game, if I didn't know or not, I'd say I knew.
That's it. But he's got to be happy with their offensive production. They've run 46 plays in the first half, and they've just done a marvelous job of mixing the run and the pass, been successful in both ends.
And James Stewart, the true freshman running back for the University of Tennessee, came in to get a yeoman's load of carrying the ball today because Aaron Hayden is hurt. He did a great job up the middle.
17 carries, 82 yards, and as you said, Bob, straight at him. And Mississippi State's going to have to close this gap. It's going to squeeze him down a little bit. Turnovers has been a significant part of the game, and here you see Plump, as he's initially inserted into the game, lays it back there on the ground. Tennessee recovers. But the Mississippi State defense has been tough all year long. They turn Stewart back to the inside, and then it's Edward Williams. The little rascal from the corner comes in and knocks it loose, and Lance Aldridge picks it up. But on fourth down, as Bob pointed out, the Volunteers go for it. Kelly in trouble, finds Corey Fleming drifting back against the grain, and 6 points for the Volunteers.
And Tennessee leads at 10-3 as you take a look at halftime stats. Mississippi State must be reasonably pleased, however, with this point of the ball game, even though, of course, they'd rather be leading than trailing.
Yeah, I wouldn't say that offensively they're very pleased at all. They don't seem to have been able to get anything going. They've got 83 yards of total offense in the first half. 38 of it came on one play. So you can bet they were doing some drawing and erasing in there at halftime. They'll come out with a little bit different look, or at least they'll perform what they planned to do initially a little bit better.
Carter and Pickens kick off. Tennessee will have the ball to begin the second half of play. When you really think about it, I said Mississippi State might be pleased. Well, they may be pleased it's only a 7-point deficit. But, you know, really defensively, Tennessee controlling the ball, too. They've got to make some stops there, too, on the Bulldog side.
Yeah, they've got to make some changes on offense and make more happen. There's no question about it. I'm sure they feel the same way.
Gardner with a kickoff. Carter at the 9.
Big play down there. It was made by the first man down on the penetration. And it was significant because Carter might have had a running lane. It'll be first down 10 at the 16.5-yard line for the Volunteers. Tennessee in the first half, they got a field goal on that first drive, 52-yarder. Then missed the 46-yard field goal.
Two 11-play drives and an 8-play drive followed by an interception and then a couple of stumbles and then back to 11 plays.
On the first down, Tennessee from the 16.5-yard line. They're going to keep trying what worked. They keep working. James Stewart out across the 25 to the 27-yard line. Keo Coleman with the tackle.
Mike Stoll, a right guard that time, did an excellent job on Danny Boyd and opened up the crack for Stewart, and he doesn't need much room.
Stewart with 18 carries on the day. That's Kenneth Campbell, stopped over on the right side of the offensive line.
Daniel Boyd coming in and sticking him. Tennessee giving Mississippi State a little of their own medicine here with a no-huddle offense.
James Stewart tries the middle again. Success again. To the 47. And that'll take Stewart over the 100-yard mark rushing the football at 20 yards of receiving to his total.
Intimate view of the ball being exchanged there.
Intimate, good choice of words.
Yeah, right. Back to Stewart, cutting it up through the middle. All great running backs are going to have that eye back to the middle of the field.
Stewart has been impressive here today. He gets his 20th carry. Not much this time, however. Keo Coleman with his sixth tackle.
Talking to some of the defensive coaches about it.
On second down, 8, the play fake. Slicing through the Bulldog defense. A gain of 25.
Play action becomes such a successful strategy when you're running the football. It'll hold the linebackers more, and Phillips just slides out of the backfield. They ran that play earlier on using Adams coming out of the backfield. Same thing.
13-11 to go in the third quarter. Tennessee leading at 10-3 with a 77-yard drive to end the half. And they don't miss a beat. They come right back and pick up where they left off. It's a beautiful day in Knoxville. Tennessee leading at 10-3. 13-11 to go, third quarter. Ball's on first down from the 26-yard line. To the 21-yard line.
A little bit different look for Kelly. Something that you usually don't see from Tennessee on first down. Moses Phillips getting some good solid playing time in there now, trying to get James Stewart a break.
Phillips with the carry. And the first down. To the 10-yard line. Redshirt freshman who's listed as a fullback, but remember Aaron Hayden is not playing today because of an injury, and so they've been using Mose Phillips in there. First of all, they came in and threw to him uncharacteristically, and now he ran off the right side.
They opened the game with that same play, a tackle trap with Rodney Gordon leading the way. 53 total plays for Tennessee. Ball control.
Kelly wants to throw it quickly and does. Complete to Pickens, who broke the tackle and then wrestles his way to the 2.5-yard line. Williams knocks him out finally. Tennessee will have it. Second down goal from the 2.5.
You see Edward Williams on the top of your screen. Got to snuggle up a little bit down here this close to the goal line. I think he was afraid of getting into a jumping contest with Pickens, but he's been doing a fine job on Pickens all afternoon.
Second down goal, let's say at the 3. Power formation for the Volunteers. Phillips airborne, no, doesn't get there.
Watch this line of scrimmage here. Tony Harris coming across, making penetration. Aldridge up over the top. Aldridge's dad, see him there, number 24, played for Texas, was a coach for Bob Tyler, the mid-70s, back at Mississippi State.
Third down goal from the 1.5. Kelly on the option, touchdown, Tennessee. Open up a 16-3 lead with a point after coming. 11:32 to go in the third quarter. It's 17-3.
Let's look at that touchdown with the high camera view here. It's blocked down, and watch Danny Boyd come in there, and he gets distracted. I'm not sure whose responsibility the quarterback is here, but he's looking for the pitch. Kelly reads that, ducks into the end zone for 6 points. Very smart play by Andy Kelly. He does it all for Tennessee. And there's a guy that is leading the troops, and most of them very inexperienced. 9 of their players from last year's offense were in NFL camps this summer. So we've seen some quarterbacks take some real lickings after having some good years early on in their career, but lose their receivers and lose an experienced line and not able to respond to those circumstances. But Andy Kelly has certainly stepped up and done an admirable job.
Chapman with the kickoff. James and Roberts are deep. Chapman gets this one into the end zone, and we've got a return on. It's James. Elusive runner out to the 26-yard line. One of the nation's leading kick returners coming back this year, Tony James, been playing with a sore ankle, which has cut down some of the moves. 83 yards, 10 plays, and 328. Averaged 6.5 yards per carry on that drive. 8 runs, 2 passes.
One play pass, one drop back.
And Sleepy Robinson back in at quarterback now after giving way to Greg Plump in the second quarter. Robinson looked like he did not want to have the ball on the handoff there. He put it into the stomach of William Prince, had to keep it, got about a yard.
As I mentioned earlier, one of the things that Tennessee does so well defensively is they get the cornerbacks into the action a lot faster. Some cornerbacks are a little reluctant to come up there and take on a running back, but Lincoln and Miley, both, neither one of them mind hitting.
Second down 9, Robinson. Again, you see Robinson stretching it out, and when he looked upfield, he saw 4 orange jerseys.
Let's watch this defensive line work here for Rex Norris. Shazan Bradley, number 40. J.J. Surlis, number 48 there, working along the line of scrimmage there to make the play. Surlis' dad played at Alabama.
Mississippi State hasn't converted on third down in this ball game. Robinson. Close to the first down. Let's see where they mark him down. The pass was complete to Willie Harris. Just depend on the spot here. He was right at the first down marker. We'll have to measure it. Boyd Miley made the stop.
And once again, Sleepy under a lot of pressure from that Lethal Weapon 4 group. They're playing without their starting strong safety. They're playing without their starting middle linebacker and still have been very effective first down for Mississippi State.
By half of the football. First third down conversion of the day. Tennessee was allowing only 25% third down conversions by opponents coming into the game. That's pretty darn good. That's a reflection of the Tennessee ball control. 19-4 edge in first downs in this game. Here's the reverse pitch to Harris. Needs a block. Gets it. Willie Harris, who's going to catch him? Willie Harris, touchdown, Mississippi State. There are no penalty flags on the field. Outstanding block by Lee Ford, number 60, the guard, to help clear him. 64 yards on the reverse.
Great counter punch by Watson Brown, coming against all that pursuit. Flips it back. And Willie Harris takes it a long way home.
64 yards for Willie Harris, the junior from Moss Point, Mississippi. Outstanding speed. Point after is good, and all of a sudden, Mississippi State's back in this ball game. 17-10, the Volunteers lead it.
Willie Harris, 64 yards. The kickoff.
And we talk about that Tennessee defense, and it's just strong upfield and taking a lot of chance. Last week we saw UCLA pop a screen pass for 74 yards.
Here's today's Phillips Petroleum leaderboard. See the kick return leaders. Carl Pickens averaging 26.7 yards per.
You have a couple eager receivers back there, Pickens and Carter. They have discussions about each one of these things as to who's going to take it. Every once in a while, the other one encroaches across midway point here. They both want the ball badly.
I might point out, by the way, we said kick. That's actually punt return yardage for Pickens. He's going to be trapped at the 12-yard line on this kickoff return. Carter, the better of the kick returners. And Pickens goes down at the 12, a return of only 8.
Mississippi State must feel the same way, Bob, as they kick it to Pickens, obviously kicking it to the left side. Oh, boy.
Kicking to Pickens. With his multiple talents, he certainly could emerge as a Heisman candidate. Obviously, the Rocket, being a kick returner and receiver, could do it. First down 10 could be a candidate. I mean, 9:34 remaining in the third quarter. Kelly with the fakes and the throw on the run. It is complete to Faulkner. From the 48-yard line. Keo Coleman finally got in from behind. And sophomore Craig Faulkner gets a 36-yard gainer.
Perfect execution by Andy Kidd. Takes his time with that fakes. Holds the linebackers, holds the defensive backs for a second. Luster just can't get there in time. Edward Williams releases his responsibility, comes back, tries to help on the tackle.
First down 10. Stewart about 2 on the right side, right near midfield. So we have explain this, Tim.
Okay.
We have 3-3 the whole first half. 2 seconds left. Tennessee finally knocks it in for a touchdown. Then wham, bam, we come back here with a 17-10 ball game.
Well, I think it's a couple of big plays. Tennessee has driven the ball all day on Mississippi State. Hadn't been able to get it into the end zone. Mississippi State came up with some big plays on defense. But this has been standard procedure for Tennessee today.
Kelly's going for all of them. Underthrown. An incomplete, almost picked off first by Williams and then almost received by Carl Pickens. 6'3", he is a constant threat.
Good job of playing the ball by Edward Williams, and as you mentioned, Carl Pickens almost makes the catch. But Williams is doing an admirable job on Pickens. He was all by himself there. He got no help on that particular play, running right with him.
From the 49 of Tennessee, third down, 8 Volunteers, 17-10 Tennessee lead, 8:37 to go, third quarter. Kelly under a pass rush. He completes it to Stewart. They set up the screen. Stewart does not get the first down. Boyd makes the tackle, number 41.
And good hustle by Rodney Stowers to get up there, all the way from his interior line position. And that's good defense. Get around the football. Both of these coordinators, Bill Clay and Larry Lacewell, both very experienced coaches.
In case you're looking in the face of that young punter there and you're saying, he looks very young. He is. True freshman, Tom Hunt. Just turned 18. Trying for a pooch kick. Wants to get this one down inside the 20. Takes a Mississippi State bounce out to the 23. And there the Bulldogs, trailing by 7, will take it over. 52 to go in the third quarter. SEC football on TBS. Along with Tim Foley, this is Bob Neal up in the booth with us. Alex Vergara and Kim Anderson doing their usual sparkling job. On the first down, Robinson remains at quarterback. Hands it to Prince, who has been frustrated all day trying to run it up the middle. That's 6 carries for about 10 yards for William Prince. Walker and Fisher back on the field for Tennessee. You see neither one of them will return. Walker the linebacker, Fisher the center. Fisher got hurt in the first period, Walker in the second. Robinson
just took a beating back there. Darrell Hardy, number 87, was the guy that got him first. He held him up just long enough for the quarterback to take another vicious lick before the whistle.
They certainly are playing the option well. Of course, Larry Lacewell, with all that experience at Oklahoma, and he ran this same kind of offense at Arkansas State after he got away from the wishbone.
Players everywhere spread out. Robinson throwing on the run. And it is complete to the 31-yard line. Darrell Hardy made the stop on Trentis Anderson, the backup tight end. It's about 3 yards short of the first down, so Mike Riley will have to come in and punt it away.
Once again, the Tennessee defense holds them to three and out, forcing them into a punting situation, which is almost like an offensive play here at Tennessee when you got Dale Carter back there.
Riley gets the good hang time, drives Carter back to the 19. Broke a tackle. And back to the 32. Oh, so dangerous. 50-yard punt, 13-yard punt return. Here's how the scoring went in the ball game. Tennessee got the 29-yard field goal in the first quarter from Wendell Bowe. Then there was no scoring until later in the quarter when Gardner hit a 46-yarder for Mississippi State, and it stayed that way until 2 seconds remained in the first half, and that's when Kelly on fourth down threw the touchdown pass to Corey Fleming and led at halftime 10-3. Then Tennessee went up 17-10 on their opening drive. Kelly took it in on an option from the line of scrimmage, and Willie Harris on the end around took it back 64 yards to make it 17-10. Now Tennessee, two Stewart. Nothing this time. Nate Williams got all the way out there to make the stop from his nose tackle position.
Nate Williams is one of the top pro prospects on this team. From his nose guard position, really covers a lot of ground. These people were booing here. They wanted a face mask call, but it looked like he just got the shoulder pad, maybe a little helmet, maybe an ear hole.
There's no ear hole call.
No ear hole call.
Second down and 10. Kelly goes to the air. He gets flushed out of the pocket by Williams and then run out of bounds. And oh, did Coleman want to get a lick on the quarterback, but Kelly got to the safety of the sideline just in time.
And a good decision by Keelcomb. You know, you made me run this far. I want to put some hurting on you, but he laid off, which was wise.
That was Nate Williams you saw going off the field there at number 95, 285 pounds. He flushed Kelly right out of the pocket. Good player.
Pete Jenkins substituting liberally in that defensive line, trying to keep his players fresh.
Third down. About five, call it a long punt. Kelly. It's Pickens for the first down to the 42-yard line. Edward Williams. 22-yard gain by Pickens. That's his fourth catch of the day for a total of 50 yards.
Let's watch the secondary here. This is blitz coverage and man-to-man bump and run. When Kelly sees this, he looks right at Pickens. And Edward Williams did a nice job. He didn't let him escape outside, but he slid underneath him and opened up for Kelly, and he rifled it right in there. If it's one-on-one, number 8's going to throw it to number 15 here in Knoxville.
Speaking of that, Pickens kind of wobbles off the field out here. Kelly lofting it up under some serious pressure back there. We'll check on Pickens. He wobbled off the field. Looked like he got his bell rung on that last play. Last night in Los Angeles, the Braves regained first place with their 3-0 win. Even here, I like the guy on the left with the Sox. I'm a Sox fan too. They almost
kept me up till 1:30.
Exactly. Well, the Braves help, but I think the secret to the success this year is Carey and Van Wieren. And oh, what a hit there by number 20 Edward Williams on McCleskey. There's Pickens on the sideline. I think they're asking him what town he's in, and he was wrong 3 out of 4 times, but when he finally got it right, they let him back on the field.
Right.
I'm only chuckling. It's not funny to get your bell rung like he did. When he wobbled off, he wasn't quite sure which sideline to go. Third down 8. Kelly It is complete, short of the first down. That'll depend on the spot now. There is a favorable Tennessee mark on that ball. Von Reeves, the receiver.
Well, Tony Harris did a fine job of jamming Pickens and then reacting back to the ball being thrown.
I think it's short of the first down.
Let's watch it here. Tony rolls up. Don't let him outside. Good jam. Okay, now get your head and shoulders around. React back and help. Fourth down.
Fourth down and less than a yard.
Looks like they've got five defensive linemen in the game now, Bob. You know, they love the either over the top or the option.
On the power game. They give the 44 Mario Brunson, the 250-pound fullback, who gets the first down off the right side. See him, he's as big as the offensive lineman.
He is a load.
Well, it looked to me like he got that first down by substantial margin, but they're coming into measure. There's an indication of Tennessee's offensive dominance of this ball game, but again, Tim, it looked to me as though he had surged forward a good couple of yards.
At least over a couple of bodies.
Yeah.
You know, you saw a couple of people going the other way.
Wait a minute. Yeah, he got it by the length of the ball.
Right. It might have been requested by Jackie Sherrill that they measure that as opposed to the official just making the decision voluntarily.
3:52 to go in the third quarter. Tennessee leading it 17-10. Was 3-3 with 2 seconds to go in the half. Tennessee punched it in on fourth down to take the 10-3 halftime lead. Came back on their opening drive and scored. And then a 64-yard end around by Willie Harris made it 17-10. Got an official's timeout down on the field. We're at Neyland Stadium in Knoxville. As you look at Jackie Sherrill, 96,000 here today, the eighth largest crowd in history. Last week was the third largest with 97,000 plus for the UCLA game. The handoff to Stewart. Stewart gets it inside the 30 to about the 29-yard line. Rodney Stowers with only his second tackle today. He's been neutralized by the Tennessee offensive line, leading tackler coming into the game.
Yes, he was a leading tackler coming into the game. That's something unusual for a defensive lineman. It tells you he's covering a lot of ground, but it also tells you the effectiveness of this Tennessee offensive line.
Kelly on the option with the pitch. Stewart met in the backfield.
Know where he's going all the time.
Third down, 12, Tennessee. Kelly with the pass drop into the pocket. It collapses on at the 36-yard line. Keith Joseph came back to get Kelly. It was third down. That'll bring up fourth and pretty long yardage.
See what it looks like here. Joseph fighting his way around the blocker. Good protection, good coverage by the secondary. Kelly couldn't get it off in time, and then one of their pass rush specialists.
In for the pooch punt. This is a place on the field where the narrower goalpost kind of take you away from even thinking about kicking a field goal here. Game play.
Right. We'll lull them to sleep.
Fourth down, 19 now. Tennessee, no place to be lulling anybody right now. They have a narrow touchdown lead. Kelly does punt the ball. Trying to drop it inside the 10. He's very good at this. Oh, his players didn't help him out. He had two men down there, but they didn't get a hand on the ball. 41-yard punt. Kelly gave him a chance to knock it down on the two. They couldn't get it done. East Tennessee on the banks of the Tennessee River. Neyland Stadium, Tennessee leading 17-10, minute 23 to go in the third quarter. First down 10, Bulldogs from their own 20-yard line. Sleepy Robinson with time to throw, and a man there just missed Chris Furrow. Some action on the sideline. Penalty marker is down, and Jackie Sherrill stepped in to keep Furl out of it. Dale Carter was covering him, number 18. Carter, you remember, was tossed from the game last week after retaliating against some UCLA players he said had twisted his knee.
That's the same pattern they ran earlier in the game, Bob, that they completed the Furl for 38 yards. Let's watch the end of this here. Tennessee in a little bit better coverage, Miley closer.
Here comes Sherrill jumping right in the middle. Right.
Personal foul on the defense. 15-yard penalty, automatic first down.
Since it was incomplete, it's marked off from the line of scrimmage, so it'll go out here to the 35-yard line, and Sherrill saw that coming. He knew that Chris was about to lose it.
Yeah, and Carter came in there with his shoulder. He didn't come in with his head. I don't think you can call that spearing.
I thought he hit him inbounds also.
Exactly.
Nevertheless, better field position for the Bulldogs, trailing by only seven. Robinson on the option and the pitch right at the last moment. And about 6 yards, it went to Charlie Davidson, the wide receiver who had come around.
Sessions there into the action on support. Kept that from developing. He's in there momentarily playing for Floyd Miley.
Well, the Bulldogs just keep on hanging in here. Tennessee dominating possession time during the extent of this ball game, but lead it only by a touchdown. Bulldogs now with second down about four. Robinson nowhere to go. He's down at the 39-yard line. Penetration, penetration, and penetration. Daryl Hardy, Todd Kelly were back there.
Drew Fabianich helps with the defensive ends here at Tennessee and helps Rex Norris with the defensive end. Watch him from this side here. Kelly is just there and just messes up. They call it getting into the mesh point. So he's faking to the fullback, and he's got no place to go with the ball. He can't get past him, and Watson a little bit discouraged there.
Third down, six. There's that rush again. Penalty markers are down in the Tennessee secondary. Pass intended for Charlie Davidson. Tennessee was coming that time. And Robinson probably had one of those hot calls, and he went right to Davidson over the middle. Let's see the penalty call.
It's going to be pass interference. Jeremy Lincoln interfered with Davidson as he broke across his face, coming across the middle.
Pass interference on the defense. It's a spot foul, automatic first down.
Two penalties have gotten Mississippi State out here to midfield.
Okay, let's watch it. Receiver on the bottom of your screen, Jeremy Lincoln, defensive back from Tennessee. You can't do that.
Robinson, look at him, he stayed alive. How did he do it? Throwing on the run, Furl, complete. Does remind me of watching Michael Jordan in the NBA. How did he do it?
I tell you, this is a lot like watching Don Smith, former superstar here that played at Mississippi State, and it was the same type of game that they had back in 1986. Look at this. This wasn't necessarily drawn up like this. Ernest Field goes over the top. Mim says, let me at him, let me at him. And then he rifles it downfield.
First and goal at the 8-yard line, trailing by seven. Big time noise here, the officials stepping into the play. That's the end of the third quarter with Mississippi State right at the doorstep. Play, big play, big play is the story.
That's about it for Mississippi State. Now they're going to find out if they can stick it in there.
Noise a factor, Ron Thulin down the sideline. I would say the answer to that is yes, noise is a factor.
Okay, Bob, the noise, it is incredible down here right now. As you can see, Tennessee has a microphone that the cheerleaders used to get the crowd riled up. But when Johnny Majors was here as head coach of the University of Pittsburgh, one of his crew cut the wires. But they're using it here today.
Oh, I know why you can't hear, Ron. You're standing in the middle of the cheerleaders.
I can fix that.
All right, we're back to the game. First and goal at the 9. Bulldogs after the spectacular play by Robinson. The pass completion to Furl.
This was Sleepy specialty last year. Short yardage and goal line.
They tried to turn it back up inside. Tennessee stayed home. Oh, did they ever. Yeah, Smokey Robinson and the Miracles again remains appropriate. We've seen so many shots of Watson Brown on the sideline like that during his days at Vanderbilt, particularly after the well-executed, well-thought-out play wasn't executed properly.
That just never had a chance to develop. You see John Chavis there in the mustache on the right. Rex Norris, the defensive line coach, standing next to him.
Second down goal from the 9. On the option, this is Sleepy Robinson. Dives inside the 5. Tennessee leading it by 7. It'll be third down and less than 5 to the goal line.
He gets turned sideways like that. He just really is hard to bring down. Just very, very elusive. And he's just as you saw Ernest Field, he left the body print on him and he couldn't get him down. Who said this guy can't throw? Did you see that? What a touch on the ball. The only place that you could stick it in there, right in the corner of the end zone.
Penalty marker is down, by the way, in the end zone. Let's check to see what that is before they line up for the point after. I think it happened after the play. So Tony James got his first touchdown reception of the year. Tony, mainly known for his kick return game, has been a running back, moved back to wide receiver this year. He did a nice job of getting open, but it was feathered in there beautifully by quarterback Sleepy Robinson. Both coaches dying to know what this penalty marker's about down there. Discussion on the sideline. William Goff on the right at the end zone. William Goss is the SEC official. Personal foul is called against Mississippi State. Now we think it came after the touchdown catch. Here's the announcement from Goss.
After the score, unsportsmanlike conduct on the offense. We'll take a 15-yard penalty on the kickoff. You have a touchdown.
So there's the call. It's against the Bulldogs. Significant point after here. Tennessee leads 17-16. Chris Gardner in for the point after. It's good. And this ball game is tied with 13-38. Remaining. So Sleepy Robinson with a spectacular scramble and long pass to Furl, and then the beautiful feathery touch. And you see Pickens injured his elbow early in the game, has continued to play. He banged up his elbow and then got his bell rung on a pass reception. So they're not taking any chances with their potential Heisman candidate. A little too early to call him that yet. An All-American Carl Pickens. There's that short kickoff because of the penalty. Carter gets it at his 18. Has some running room. And is out to the 36-yard line. Return of 22 yards. So that penalty hurt. Tennessee with decent field position. And here's the scoring drive. Jim Artist on the feed into the end zone. On first down. Tennessee running, but Mississippi State is there. Right up the middle. Play of James Stewart was just creamed by Arlie Gibson.
That was that tackle trap again that they've run very effectively, but that time it didn't happen. They've just seen it enough. And there's Pete Jenkins, a defensive line coach here at Mississippi State, 11 years at LSU, has sent 19 into the NFL.
Second down, about 13. Kelly. It's picked off. Keo Coleman at the 40. He got a block. Needs another. Kelly's the only man there. Coleman. He's out of bounds at the 4. A
43-yard return on the interception by Keo Coleman. They knocked him out at the four, and the Bulldogs with an opportunity to take the lead in this game and the seventh interception of the year for Andy Kelly.
Well, the defensive staff of Mississippi State has to be proud of the way these guys have hung in there. That time, Andy Kelly just stayed with Pickens too long across the middle. He looked at him for too long. Coleman had dropped to the left. He saw and read the quarterback, started moving back to the right, and made the catch. Great catch and run by Keo Coleman, who had a reputation at being good against the run, but not very good against in pass defense.
Jackie Sherrill's wanting a timeout down there. Let's see if he gets it called. It'll be first down goal at the four. Yes, timeout, Mississippi State. Tennessee's turnovers killing him. In 1990, Tennessee led the nation with plus 23 in the takeaway giveaways. And in 1991, Tennessee came into this game last in the SEC. They've had three turnovers here today. And Johnny Major said it was a significant problem for this version of the University of Tennessee Volunteers. Defensive unit with a challenge on their shoulders. First and goal from the four. Robinson keeps it, turns it upfield, gets to the one, maybe inside the one. Let's take a look at Keo Coleman working.
You see Kelly, look to his left. He's watching Pickens. He's following Pickens across and doesn't happen to pick up Keo Coleman coming from the backside, from his weak linebacker position. Never really got into Kelly's field of view. Now watch this play by Andy Kelly. And that's why they love him. Fighting and scrapping to knock the guy out of bounds to give Tennessee a chance to play again. Line up and play again.
Bulldogs have it less than the length of the football away from the end zone. You see how close it is. Second down, goal. Prince. The Bulldogs have taken the lead at Neyland Stadium in Knoxville. Tennessee was a two-touchdown favorite in this game. William Prince got his third rushing touchdown of the year, and it's 23-17 Bulldogs.
As it felt like they had. And now they're going to have to get off their backs and get going.
Point after is good. It's 24-17. The Bulldogs have the 7-point lead, and that's 21 unanswered points from Mississippi State.
Bob and Tim, one thing Jackie Sherrill did at Pittsburgh, and he also did it at Texas A&M. He made his players believe, right?
Coleman, the senior from Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Eight tackles in this game today, and that big 43-yard interception return that set up the touchdown. And the Bulldogs have taken the lead with 21 unanswered points. They trail 17-3. Gardner nails the kickoff. 3 yards deep in the end zone. And he's so dangerous. Tony Harris gets him out of bounds and wisely let go out there at the 28.5-yard line. And Tennessee will set it up there. That's about a 30-yard kickoff return there, however, by Dale Carter. Just a bomb waiting to explode.
In high school, he didn't play in a game his senior year that he didn't return a kick for a touchdown. I mean, he's an expert at it. But Mississippi State's been doing a good job of covering those kicks. He hasn't had a lot of room. They've been hanging on to him.
On first down 10, Tennessee trailing for the first time in this ball game. 11 and a half minutes to go. Kelly rolling for throwing room. It is complete to McCleskey out here to the 38-yard line. Johnny Majors got that houndstooth jacket off there when he got a little bit tense seeing what's happened late in the game. He's back into it now. Not that he was ever out of it.
Oh, but this is a very inexperienced team, too, with so many new starters, Bob, and you lose track of... You don't know how fast the game can get away from you. John's been coaching long enough. He knows how quickly it can drift away.
And we notice the true freshman, Stewart, the running back's out of there. And you see who's in, 19, Mose Phillips. And we questioned, certainly not the courage or anything, but an 18-year-old true freshman carrying the football as many times as Stewart did. And today he's carried it 27 times.
Okay, now here's a real problem. You can see in your screen there, number 50, Tom Myslinski limping off the field. Now, that could be a cramp. it might be a knee. He's walking rather stiff-legged, and he and Fisher are the leaders in that offensive line. Those are the two folks that come back, the returners. They're veterans, and they're not in there now.
Fisher in street clothes. He was hurt in the first quarter. Kelly on the run. Joseph pursuing, but he gets it off. It's almost picked off by Harris. That ball sailed on Kelly, intended for McCleskey. It can't sail much on McCleskey. He's only 5'8". But
he's a competitive little rascal, a defensive back that they made into a receiver simply because there was a dearth of talent in that area. But Kelly's just got to settle down, take a deep breath, and Johnny said one of the good things about him is that he did not get bothered by his mistakes. He wouldn't get down on himself, but he's got to relax a little bit here, realize that he's got 11 minutes to go, and that's a long time as far as he's concerned.
Second down, 10. Kelly gives again to Phillips, who breaks the tackle. He's finally tripped up by Woodard. Not much gain, if any, on the play. This is the first time all year, of course, Tennessee played only two games, but this is the first time Tennessee has trailed. Two games and three quarters.
Well, as strong as their defense has been, that really is not a surprise. This afternoon, turnovers have got them in a little trouble.
On third down, 10, Kelly. Rolling to throw, hits Phillips. Who breaks tackles, three, four tackles. Phillips with an outstanding job of running after the catch to the 46-yard line, a gain of 14. Frankie Luster finally got him.
As our statistician Alex Bagheera had pointed out in the first half, Kelly spread it around to eight different guys, so he isn't locked into any one person. That time, a good job of covering McCleskey downfield, resulting in the dump to Phillips, and then just some good running there, tackle breaking.
On the first and 10 from the 46 of the Bulldogs now. They're trying to run it up the middle again. This is Phillips.
Phillips to the 26-yard line. Well, first, Aaron Hayden was the freshman who ran the ball so well. He got hurt. Stewart had to step in here today in his place. It gained 110 before he went out. Now he gets backed up by Mose Phillips, a redshirt freshman. And he gets 20 on that carry.
Let's watch the draw in here, Bob. You're going to see a little sweep blocking in here, and then Phillips breaks it up through the middle. Just a fine job of running. See the tight end sneak in there. Phillips finds a hole, gets a block on the linebacker, keeps them from getting into that play early.
Stewart's back in there. He's going to take the screen pass.
And he breaks the tackle. Stewart to the 23-yard line. Tony Harris finally got in.
Frankie Luster had him right there where he caught the pass, but Stewart eluded that tackle.
People in the secondary from Mississippi State are going to have to hang on. You know, they're getting there in good time. Just hang on. Running backs for Tennessee breaking tackles, making progress after the first impact.
Tennessee trailing for the first time this year, 24-17. 9 minutes to go in this game on the drive. Kelly pumps left, then goes a little bit longer. Overthrows his intended receiver. That's Corey Fleming.
Good job by Tony Harris. Kelly pumped. Fleming tried to clear him. Harris jammed him, which is legal. Made Fleming avoid him, and it just threw the timing off. It's interesting that Pickens is not in the game now.
Yeah, Pickens is not there. As a matter of fact, he doesn't even have his helmet down on the sideline. They've taken his helmet away, we understand, from Ron Thulin, who's down there, so he can't return to the game. Remember, Pickens had his bell rung earlier. They may be just trying to protect the young man from injury. Kelly slides down at the 13-yard line. You see Majors talking to Carl Pickens. He's the All-American. He's been banged around a lot this game. He's not happy about this at all. You see the look on his face.
You see, there's no containment on this play. Kelly comes out clean. Somebody's got to get upfield. Nobody's there, so Kelly can either throw it or run it. He decides to run. Good coverage downfield on the wide receivers.
He gets the first down from the 13. They'll try to run it again. This is Pickens. Look at the power.
To the 7-yard line goes the redshirt freshman from Nashville.
Carl wanting back in this game. He hurt his elbow early in the game, and then we saw him wobble off the field after a pass reception previously. He's been back in there, but again, they've taken him off the kickoff return team. Him back for the game. Trying to protect his health. Kelly on the fake and the roll. Tipped away beautifully right at the last second by Edward Williams. Intended for Corey Fleming.
Mississippi State has got to get some containment up there on that roll. That time they had the same look. The tight end was open. Kelly could have dumped it there. He saw Fleming coming open across the back. See, there's nothing there. Spivey's out in front of him. Great play by Edward Williams, making up ground on Fleming. That little rascal's had a good game. I mean, he's been nose to nose with Carl Pickens more times than you'd like to be this afternoon.
13th play of the drive. Third down. Kelly. Kelly was buried just as he threw the ball, and it will bring up fourth down. Tennessee's not going to do that. They're going to just try to get some points on the board here because there's 7:44 remaining in the game, and Johnny Majors has seen that this team is able to move the ball against Mississippi State.
Kelly steps up, gets nailed as he releases the ball. Faulkner almost had it. Beautiful throw, low into the outside. Harris has no chance. Keith Joseph coming around the corner. Stallworth up the middle. Excellent pressure.
24-yard field goal attempt from Wendell Bowe. It is good. It is Mississippi State 24, Tennessee 20, 7:39.
Out of the game, and he came out wobbling, and that is the reason he is not in right now. But he says he feels fine. The doctors and the medical staff say, you're not going back in, and he has argued with everyone, from the trainers to even Coach Majors, but he's going to be sitting down.
Nope, he's still going at it. He won't hurt himself arguing that way. This is Kenny Roberts from the goal line to the 14-yard line. Hit was made by Eric Riffer. Now this crowd is going to become a factor as the Bulldogs have to line up down at the closed in end of this stadium.
There will be no audibles down there. It will be hand signals. That's the only thing that you're going to be able to get out.
Robinson keeps it for about three. Out near the 20. Casey Rogers made the stop for Tennessee. Clock is ticking down. 7:20 to go in the ball game. By the way, Mississippi State has only one timeout remaining. They don't really care about that as long as they have the lead. Tennessee has all three of their timeouts.
Comes to a point here where you almost have to huddle to get the play call from the sideline.
From the 19-yard line, second down. Robinson with the pitch. This is Kenny Roberts. He gets the first down. Turns on the speed and gets it out of bounds at the 37-yard line. A very big play on the option as Kenny Roberts takes the pitch from Sleepy Robinson. A gain of 18.
That time the containment that has been there all afternoon just didn't show up in time. Robinson did the proper thing. Tracy Smith was the force man. Should have been up there a little bit quicker. Mark Fletcher drives him out of bounds, but a big gain. And in terms of field position, very important play for Mississippi State.
Roberts will try the right side. Got a little running room there across the 40. Gain of about three. Tripped up by Shazan Bradley. And the clock continues to tick down. 6:37, 36, 35, and ticking. Mississippi State undefeated coming into this game. 24th ranked. Tennessee 6th ranked. And Jackie Sherrill wanting the upset and to keep this miracle kind of season alive. People keep asking me, are the Bulldogs for real? I think if you've seen this game today, whatever happened, you have to say, yes, they are. Robinson tosses to Roberts. Needs a block. Gets it. Stopped short of the first down by a big hit by Dale Carter. That's why he's a preseason All-American pick, right at the 45.
Big hit there by Casey Rogers, too, on that particular play. Took out Sleepy Robinson. Big hit on the sidelines by Carter. Now watch Sleepy get it from Casey. Roger. Boom. He goes down. Roberts out there. Carter's got him trapped on the sideline. Great angle and just drills him out of bounds.
Third down two. Robinson on the throw. Out of bounds. He had the first down. Tended for Willie Harris. Robinson had the first down on that rollout. Well, he's got to make the call in the thick of battle while being pursued, and Watson Brown knows he had the first down also. Just has to make the call. That's William Robinson has made that judgment correctly more often than not.
And as a quarterback, as a competitor, forget whatever position you're playing. You want to make the play. You want to do something good. You want to make something happen, and he felt like he had an opportunity there.
Riley in for the punt. And it's a good one. Carter will take it at the 8-yard line. Stutter step breaks up field. Excellent coverage. He gets the 12-yard line before Wesley Lisi makes this stop. A 47-yard punt. And Carl Pickens, you got to hear me, Carl Pickens has talked his way back in this game. Tennessee needs him too. First and 10 from their own 12. Kelly. In as he throws. McCluskey reverses field. Runs out of bounds at the 49-yard line. A gain of 37. I don't want to overhype Carl Pickens, but one of the things he brings, Tim, is you have to give him so much attention.
That's exactly right, and it leaves everybody else man-to-man. This time they're playing a 3-deep zone here, and Williams is just playing way off, got too much room. This gives McCluskey a chance to start motoring a little bit and use that athletic ability. This is an intense competitor. Comes up with a big play.
First down 10. Kelly is over 300 yards passing today. Incomplete. Short hop that one intended for Ronald Davis. Clock, obviously the factor. 5:26 remaining in the game. Mississippi State leading it by 4. Tennessee needs the touchdown. The Bulldogs had not given up a touchdown in 14 quarters just before the end of the half.
And if Andy Kelly would have a deficiency from up here, you can see it, and from your position on the field as a defensive back, you can see it. I think he tends to eyeball a receiver a little bit too long.
Now on second down, Pickens is out of there. Kelly rolling to buy time. What a grab at the 37-yard line by Corey Fleming. It was thrown behind him. He put on the brakes, went down for the catch.
Andy Kelly guns it in there. What he's looking for in a flat isn't open. Good coverage. Good containment by Mississippi State. Fleming puts on the skids and makes the catch. Way to rifle it in there.
At the 37 of the Bulldogs. First down 10, 5 minutes to go in the game. Mississippi State up by 4. Here's Phillips on the draw. Breaking tackles. He broke 3 of them before Coleman finally made his 9th tackle of the day for the Bulldogs. A lot of action, not much gain there. It'll be second down 7, clock at 4:39 down to the lower right and ticking. Tennessee with all 3 timeouts remaining.
I think one of the most important tools that Mississippi State can use is pressure. They don't necessarily have to blitz to use it, but they need to get pressure with Joseph and those 3 down linemen. They don't want to change anything that they've been doing this whole game, but it's worked.
Pickens back in there. 4 wideouts for Tennessee. They give it to Phillips. Look at him go. Tackles. They drag him down at the 24.
Well, we've seen it time after time here in Tennessee. Someone goes down and someone else emerges. Cobb went down. Webb stepped up. Webb went down. Tony Thompson stepped up. The last time we did Tennessee, Mississippi State, Thompson rushed for 248 yards. So
68 today for Phillips. 113 for Stewart. Kelly throwing on the run. He completes it to Faulkner at the 20. Stop there. Clock a major factor. 3:48, 3:47 and counting.
Mississippi State has been a big play defense in the critical times in the football game against Texas. They came up with turnovers. They came up with big plays, and that's what has to happen now.
Second down, 7, Tennessee. The line of scrimmage, the 21 of Mississippi State. Bulldogs lead it by 4. Clock down to 3:20. Kelly with a short drop.
Intended for Pickens, pass interference. At this point in the field, it'll be half the distance. Edward Williams got his arm on it.
So that'll move it right down there to right around the 10-yard line.
Well, when you get in one, here he is, man-to-man, Edward Williams. Stick, jab him in there, and now the ball starts to come, and he's hung on a little bit too long with that right arm.
Foul, automatic first down.
But Edward Williams is playing Pickens tooth and nail here. I mean, he's going after him. He's not giving him that quick outside release. He jammed him coming inside, and he's hanging in there. And he's giving away 5 inches or 6 inches to Pickens.
So that's defensive holding. Gives them only 5 yards, but first down. They do spot it at the 15. They hand it off to Kenneth Campbell. Drives to the 8-yard line, and Coleman has to make the play again. 3:05 to go in the game.
See, on that particular play, they brought Keith Joseph to the outside to get head up on Pickens because they didn't want to put Williams in that situation again. Of course, you take the linebacker out of there. Now he's not there to help on the run.
Second down and 3 for the first down. The first down marker right at the 5. Phillips back in there as the single setback. Kelly on the option to Phillips. They're going to throw him for a loss, and also helmets go flying down there. I think it's Phillips. Keith Joseph made the stop. Clock still ticking down, now at 2:23. It'll be third down and 5 for Tennessee, trailing by 4 points.
So now you're figuring this is a 2-down area, no question about it. You still have the option to run here, as Tennessee has shown a tendency to do over the years.
Phillips remains in at tailback. He's the single setback. Pickens in motion.
In the flat.
Kelly under pressure. It's a touchdown. Mark Adams.
Point coming up here as Tennessee leads it by 2, 26-24, with 1:50 to go, and the Bulldogs will have only one timeout for their possession. It's no good. A significant miss by Wendell Bowe, and the Bulldogs have 1:50 to attempt a field goal, which would give them a lead if successful.
Here, man-to-man on the wide side. Mississippi State thinking here that it's going to be thrown to the wide side. Danny Boyd back there, man-to-man on the tight end. Gets caught up in the play action. Mark Adams kind of sneaks away from him. And that will happen to you, and it's a touchdown. Faulkner was open coming across the middle. We'll look at it from another angle. Excellent call. Looked like Woodard was hitting him as the ball was being released. Big play for Tennessee.
1:50 to go. Bulldogs with one timeout, trailing by 2. Tony James is going to just save the clock, touch it down in the end zone. Intelligent play. Out to the 20, where the Bulldogs will go on offense with 1:50 to go. The big play out of this 88 was the 37-yard reception and run after the catch to McCleskey.
He was a big play guy for him last year on defense, and you could just see him walk around on the sidelines, walking back to the huddle. I mean, he's ready to go. He brings kind of a defensive mentality into that offensive huddle.
First down from the 20. Robinson gonna run it. Gets the first down just across the 30, and that'll stop the clock. That used only 11, 12, 13. Well, it's still running. Then I'll stop it after 13 seconds elapsed. Minute 37. They'll start it as soon as they set these sticks.
How close do they have to get, Bob? You're the kicking expert.
Thanks for making me the kicking expert. I'd say the 25-yard line. They'll try one at the 30. Gardner hit one today. Incomplete. He had a man open momentarily out there, Willie Harris. Gardner hit a 46-yarder earlier today. Second down and 10, clock at 1:20. Well, it's been a big play day for the Bulldogs. Tennessee has dominated the clock, dominated control in terms of number of plays, number of first downs. The Bulldogs are looking for one more big play.
Tennessee playing a two-deep defense here, Bob. At least give them a two-deep look. You got to try to get somebody down the middle of the field.
Robinson hit as he threw it. That's why that didn't connect. It'll be third and 10. Once again, the tremendous penetration. Chris Mims was back there.
And this is how these guys like it. Look at Todd Kelly teeing off. Mims around the corner. Dex Robinson just as he lets it go.
It's third down, but the Bulldogs, with a minute 16 to go in the ballgame and trailing by two, will use both of the downs, obviously, to keep their drive alive if they can.
Get them on the move. Get them running.
Robinson pops it over the middle. Missed everybody. Intended for Kenny Roberts. It'll be fourth down, 10. Oh, this entire crowd will now be going bonkers here at Neyland Stadium for this fourth down play by the Bulldogs.
Quarterback moving, Bob. Robinson seems to do better throwing the ball actually when he's on the run. But if he tries to sit in that pocket, you just can't, you can't keep those lethal weapon four out of there.
He sits in the pocket. He is hit. He fumbles. It wouldn't have mattered anyway. And listen to this crowd. Tennessee's probably going to hold on to their number six ranking and their undefeated season, but just by the skin of their necks.
So what's the pass rush here? You see Fuller, 91. Mims coming around the outside. He's the first one to crack through.
And Tim, it looks like Robinson may have been injured on that play.
Well, you know, he's been playing with an injured ankle all afternoon. And Tennessee sideline erupts.
Tennessee now will just try to run this clock out. The Bulldogs do have one timeout remaining. 1 minute left, and they'll just run it out. And we'll be checking on the status with Sleepy Robinson, the Mississippi State quarterback, who was carried off the field after that play. They literally had him carried, but then he stumbled away on his own back to the sideline. So we'll check on his shape. But the story of the game is Tennessee's 88-yard drive. They started at their own 12 and executed their offense when they had to.
Big play by J.J. McCleskey. Mose Phillips really came on and played an integral part of their success in the second half.
Well, Jackie Sherrill's team will taste defeat for the first time this year. And now we'll have to go down to Orlando to play the fifth-ranked Florida Gators next week. But this is a for real football team, and they can find all kinds of ways to hurt you and beat you. Tennessee with a courageous victory. They led 17-3, gave up 21 unanswered points, and came back for the victory 26-24. Two old friends, Johnny Majors, gave Jackie Sherrill his first job. Johnny was 32 at Iowa State. Jackie Sherrill was only 25 years old. They remain friends and adversaries, and now they're 1-1. Sherrill's 1980 Pittsburgh team defeated Tennessee here, and now Johnny Majors gets it back 26-24. But the Vols and Andy Kelly, who threw today for 330 yards, had to fight hard to get it.
Penalties by the NCAA this past week, the sixth-ranked Volunteers can now fully concentrate on the field business at hand. Visiting jam-packed Neyland Stadium yesterday afternoon, Jackie Sherrill surprising Mississippi State Bulldogs, who had yet to give up a touchdown in three games going in. Mississippi State got beat, but they gave the Volunteers all they can handle. Third quarter down 17-3. That is Willie Harris on the reverse, and he goes 63 yards for the touchdown. Tennessee's lead cut to 17-10. Then they were tied at 17. Andy Kelly has his pass picked off by Keo Coleman, and Coleman sets up Mississippi State's go-ahead touchdown by returning it all the way to the four-yard line. The Bulldogs were trying to pull off the upset, but Tennessee would pull it out. Andy Kelly, 27-41 for 330 yards, two touchdown passes. This one to Mark Adams with a minute 50 to go in the game. Put it on ice for Tennessee, but they beat Mississippi State only by 26-24. So did the Volunteers' narrow escape in Knoxville cost them any ground.
Well, Mississippi State almost got the Volunteers here. Tim and I were here in 1986 when Mississippi State won 27-23, upsetting Tennessee behind Don Smith. It looked like that Sleepy Robinson was going to do that today with his Bulldogs, but the quarterback of the day and the man who really did the job when he had to, with 330 yards, two touchdowns, Andy Kelly. He's with Ron Thulin.
All right, thank you, Bob and Tim. Bob was giving your statistics, a couple of touchdowns. You had a couple of key drives. First of all, right at the end of the first half, how important it was not only for the team but also for the offense to say, hey, we can punch the ball in.
Well, I think it was for our whole team. We were moving the ball okay, and we were stopping ourselves, turnovers, interceptions, fumbles, and a lot of credit to their defense because they did a good job. But we got something going there late in the second half. It's our two-minute drill, something we work on practically every day. And our guys responded well and read the coverages, and we were just able to move the ball down the field slowly.
Now, Coach Major said he really wanted to see if he could get a balance between passing and running today, and he really did that. You got some work from the freshman in the tailback position and the passing. Pretty balanced offense?
Well, I think we did. The first game, we ran the ball pretty well, and the second game, we threw the ball. And that was one of our goals this week, to come out and get a balanced attack, and we did that. I think Mose Phillips came in the second half and did a tremendous job running the ball for not having much experience. And then Little Man did a great job in the first half, and we were able to get things going. They were both running and passing.
Well, 2 weeks in a row, TBS's player of the game. Congratulations, Andy. Excellent job. Let's go back up to Bob and Tim.
Senior leader on this football team, Ron Thulin. And Andy Kelly gets our player of the game. We'll talk about that in a moment. 330 yards, two touchdowns. He did throw two interceptions, but did the job when he had to. James Stewart, his nickname Little Man, is the man that Andy Kelly was referring to. He had 113 yards rushing today. We'll be right back.
SEC football on TBS, Mississippi State at Tennessee, has been brought to you by Aflac, insuring over 35 million people worldwide, and by Dr. Pepper Company and your local Dr. Pepper bottler. Dr. Pepper is just what the doctor ordered. And by Buick and your local Buick dealers. Remember, Buick, the new symbol for quality in America. And by Coors Light, the silver bullet is the right beer now.
The final score from Knoxville, UT 26, Mississippi State 24. And our player of the game, you met him just a moment ago, Andy Kelly, 330 yards, two touchdown passes. He had two interceptions, but certainly executed the offensive game plan of Tennessee when he had to, particularly that beautifully done 88-yard drive to come back and get the go-ahead touchdown for the Volunteers. TBS Sports proud to donate $1,000 to the General Scholarship Fund of the University of Tennessee. Next week,